Hello students, so today we are going to study the chapter The Elephant Babysitter from class 7 written by Nora Burr. Okay, so these are some of the activities that you have to do before you move on to the story. So lesson 1, introduction. A babysitter is someone who looks after a baby when its parents are away. Since the title of the story is The Elephant Babysitter, so you must know the meaning of the babysitter. Now, who is babysitter? Babysitter is someone who looks after a baby when its parents are away. Okay, so he is someone who looks after the baby when parents are away. So next is list down the qualities you would expect of a good babysitter. Now what you need to do here is you have to make a list of qualities that you expect of a good babysitter. If you want a babysitter at your home, okay, what are the qualities that you expect of a good babysitter? For example, a babysitter must be punctual, loyal, protective, trustworthy, etc. So you should make a list of the qualities that you expect of a good babysitter, and then you have to compare your list with the person sitting next to you, with the friends sitting next to you. So next is, in this lesson you are going to read a story entitled The Elephant Babysitter. So the title of the story is The Elephant Babysitter. Now meaning of some words and phrases used in the story are given below. So some of the meanings are given below. Now the number after each meaning indicates the paragraph where the word is used. Now you can see there are meanings given to you. For example, we can see enter into, and then there is some number 1. Okay, you can see number 1 and it is inside the bracket. So that 1 indicates the paragraph. Okay, enter into is the meaning. So the words you can find it in the para 1 of the story. So find the word and understand its meaning before you read the whole story. So you have to find that word in those paragraph and understand its meaning before you read the whole story. So I have done it for you. Oh, all right. So enter into, so I found a word, penetrate. Penetrate means enter into. Tied an animal with a rope or a chain, tethered, held back, control, restrain, very big, immense, animal that feed on the flesh of dead animals, scavenger, hateful, very nasty, loathsome, worried, disturbed, agitated, long high cries, squealed, pulling very hard, strain, to be very surprised and not know what to do, nonplussed, eyes that see well in the night, nocturnal, and anger and excitement, exasperation, not tied, looseness, slack, unfaithful person, traitor, shout with wild uncontrolled anger, raged, swift flowing part of river, rapid, pulled hard, heaved, hurt, bruised, grief, sadness of one's wrongdoing, remorse. Now read the story. Okay. The Elephant Babysitter. Now the title of the story is Elephant the Babysitter. So you must have seen an elephant. So this is the elephant. To his keeper. Now who is keeper? Keeper, person who take care of something. Keeper bhaneko chha tyo jasle chai take care of something, just like hair cha usko hair bichar garne, that is the Karim. So Karim is a keeper of Gajapati. So now Gajapati is the name of an elephant. So to the Karim, Gajapati was the biggest, best and most intelligent elephant in all Asia. Gajapati is biggest, then best and most intelligent elephant in all Asia. So now the meaning of intelligent is who is very brilliant, Gyani, Buddhimani, elephant in all Asia. So he belonged to the India's Forest Department and was employed in the Himalayan foothills as a shikar, a hunting elephant. So he belongs to the India's Forest Department. His job was in the Himalayan's foothill as a hunting elephant. So he could penetrate the jungle like no other elephant. So penetrate, we have done it in the beginning, that the meaning of the penetrate is enter into. So he could penetrate the whole jungle like no other animal. So now here is the physical descriptions of the Gajapati. Gajapati stood 10 feet tall and weighed more than 4 tons. So height, it is 10 feet tall, weight more than 4 tons. 4 tons bhanda pani beshi usko weight cha re. His legs were like trees, sturdy, strong, his legs the elephant have. And his tracks 20 inches across, the tracks are 20 inches. And he had more than once stamped a bear to a pulp. And he had more than once stamped a bear to a pulp. That means his feet are so big, he can stamp. Stamp means what? To bring down a bear. And he could just pulp it, mash garnu sakcha re, kichaunu sakcha re. Yet Gajapati was a gentle animal, but Gajapati was a very gentle animal. So gentle means he is very kind, loving. So he was especially so with Karim. He was very much attached to the Karim, whom Gajapati loved with unselfish devotion. So Gajapati loved his keeper Karim with unselfish devotion. The Gajapati was very loyal, towards the Karim. And with Karim's infant son, and he also loved Karim's infant son very much. If the elephant was doing nothing when Karim's wife had water to fetch or dinner to cook, sometimes when the Karim's wife is busy, she had to fetch the water from the river, or sometimes she need to cook dinner. So that time, she or Karim would draw a circle in the dust in front of the tethered animal. Tethered animal, Gajapati, tethered means tied with the rope or a chain. Gajapati lai chai bandhera with chain or rope le tied karera rakhtyo. So they used to made a circle in front of the animal, in front of the Gajapati, and put the baby into the circle. So keep him aside there, O lot of elephants, they would utter the big tusker who gently restrain the child if he tried to crawl away. And then they used to order the elephant to keep inside the child, don't let the child go out of the circle. They used to do that, and the elephant gently restrain. He gently take care of a child and restrain the child from crawling away from the line, from the circle. So one afternoon when they were camped near the Rapti River, in the Rapti River. So Karim's wife took a big earthen jar and went off towards the river to fill it. So Karim's wife, she took a big earthen jar to went off towards the river to fill the water. So after a while, she was failed to return. She didn't return to the camp, and Karim shouted in every direction she had, you know, in the direction she had taken, but there was no reply. So Karim was really worried about his wife. So he shouted in the directions where she went So, but there was no reply from her. So at his yell, every jungle sound had stopped except the roar of the river. So there was no sound except the roar of the sound of a river. So then quite suddenly Karim with his heel marked a circle in front of the elephant and put the baby into it. So as usual, Karim marked a circle in front of the elephant, okay, and put the baby into it. And put the baby into it and then look after him, Gajapati. And again Karim asked the Gajapati to look after the baby, and he ran full speed to see what next. So he ran full speed to see what had happened to his wife. So he was really worried that his wife didn't return. So he ran away and to see what had happened to his wife. So under Gajapati's strong neck, next to his immense toenails, the baby lay and laughed up at the elephant. So the infant could do as he liked, but each time he tried to crawl out of the circle, he was picked up and put back in again. So now under the Gajapati's trunk, the baby lie. Okay, so the baby laughed up at the elephant. You know, he liked the elephant, but each time the baby tried to crawl out of the circle, Gajapati used to pick up the baby and put it back again in the circle. So Gajapati scooped up some dust with his trunk. Okay, sometimes Gajapati scooped some dust. Alikati dusty pair of scoop corridor, you know, with his trunk, blew it over himself. Right? So he just tried to entertain the baby. Afno body ma flick, to blew it over himself. Sometimes he flicked a little dirt over the baby, and sometimes he also flicked a little dirt over the baby. Nani Makipini, sometimes he used to flick the dirt to discourage flies. So flies are not ours. He used to flick some dirt on the child's body also. And sometimes drop of green speed fell from Gajapati's pointed underlip into the baby's tummy and tickled him. And then actually the elephant is trying to entertain the baby. He tried to keep the baby happy. Okay, so he is giving his best to entertain the baby. So sometimes what he spit, green spit fell from the Gajapati's underlip, so into the baby's tummy, and the spit fell into the baby's tummy, and the elephant used to tickle the baby. So they were perfectly content together, right? So elephant and the baby, they were really satisfied and they were really happy together. So here inside the cool shade of a huge mango tree to which Gajapati was tethered, time meant nothing. So they were under the huge mango tree where the Gajapati was tethered, okay? And the time meant nothing. Suddenly the sun was gone, drawing over it in the sky of a velvet and diamonds. Immediately the air was colder and the baby began to cry. So suddenly it was a evening time and then the air was colder, right? Especially when it is a evening, the air become more cooler, and then the baby began to cry. Maybe the baby is hungry now, okay? Maybe the baby is missing his parents. So jackals howled in the dusk, and there came the woof of an eagle. So jackals, they are the wild dogs, right? They started a howl, right? they made a cry, and then even the woof of an eagle, all this, they you know, especially in the evening time, we can heard the sound of an eagle owl, so they also began to woof. So not far away in the rough grassland, what appears? A rough grassland, a male hyena emerged from his burrow and stood silently sniffing the night air for a news of a food. So these hyenas, they stood silently, and they are looking for the food. He was a scavenger, okay? Scavenger, you did it in the beginning of the activity, that the scavengers are the animals that feeds on the flesh of a dead animals. Unale chai flesh, masu, dead animals ko masu haru khancha. And then of carrion and an eater of a skeleton, sorry, ko gale ko, you know, they used to eat. And then they are the eater of a skeleton, even the bones, skeletons, they used to eat. So he would pick up any small helpless creatures. You can see the pictures of the hyena. So they will pick up any, you know, small helpless creature they might find. And in India, hyenas take human children every year, right? So in India, hyenas take human children every year. So his mate and an almost full grown young hyena came out of a den. So now there are so many hyenas, you know, coming out of their den, looking out for the food. When they heard the baby crying, and then the little baby was crying, and then they heard the baby crying, okay, who was with the Gajapati. This bold and a loathsome beast with their powerful crushing teeth toward off in that direction. So now they are, since they are very hungry, and when they heard the baby crying, so they just powerful crushing teeth, they went off in that directions looking for. Okay, so in camp, Gajapati was beginning to be agitated about the child. He realized that something was the matter, but what? He offered the baby a mouthful of leaves and fanned him. It was no good. He put up his trunk and trumpeted for the owners of the baby to come back and do something. So now Gajapati began to be really worried about the child, because he already realized that something is not good. Okay, so he offered the baby a mouthful of leaves since a baby was crying, and he fanned him to calm the baby. And he already realized that it was not a good sign. So he put up his trunk and trumpet for the owner. So he made a loud cry. Okay, he really wanted the owners to come back and do something to protect the baby. So, but they did not appear. So unfortunately, they didn't came back. So now the Gajapati scented the hyenas. He froze and fell the bridge with his trunk to find out more. So the Gajapati can smell the hyenas, and he stand still and he try to smell and try to find out how many hyenas are there. So there were three of them out of sight but quite close. Gajapati gathered the baby closer to his feet and squealed a threat. So now Gajapati realized that there are three hyenas which is out of sight, but they are very close and soon they can attack the baby. So Gajapati gathered the baby closer to him, to his feet, and squealed a threat and make a sound, you know. Then an elephant sense of smell is acute. Elephant sense of smell is very strong, but they used to have a very poor vision, right? They cannot see the things that is far away. So that is why the it was not till the hyenas were in the camp that Gajapati saw him. The sight made him rage angrily, straining and chain that bound him. The elephant grumbled and blew. So the Gajapati couldn't see the hyenas until and unless they were in the camp. So the sight made team rage angrily, and then as soon as Gajapati realized they are in the camp now, so he angrily he made a loud cry, and he tried to free himself from the chain which was bound him, and so that he could free himself and he could help the baby. So the elephant grumbled and blew. So now The hyenas were nonplussed. Okay, so the hyenas were very surprised to see the elephant, right? Because they saw the elephant who is there to save the baby. So they were really surprised and they don't know what to do. So one sat down out of the reach and fixed his nocturnal eyes on the child. The others began to circle around behind. So now one of the hyenas sat down and fixed his eyes, nocturnal eyes, okay, which could see very well in the night. And then others, two of them, began to circle around behind. So in sudden exasperation, the elephant put his forehead against the mango tree. So now the elephant was really worried about the baby. You know, if the hyenas reached to the baby, they will definitely hurt the baby and they will eat. So now he really wanted to free himself so that he can help the baby. So you know, the elephant put all his strength against the mango tree and he tried to free himself from that giant tree, you know. So with all his strength he tried to break it down, but he did not succeed. But the tree grown at the roots, okay, he put all his strength to break the tree, but he was not succeed, but only the he felt the crack of the roots of the mango tree. So Gajapati swung back and made for a sitting hyenas, which sprang smartly away. So again, the hyenas were waiting for the chance. So they tried to attack the baby, and then again the Gajapati whirled towards him, and then the hyenas jumped out of the reach. He attacked the tree again. Now again Gajapati attacked the tree. As you know, he really, his intention was to free himself from that mango tree, from that chain, and save the baby. It shrieked as it struck against it. So he put all his efforts to break the mango tree, but now the baby was yelling at the top of his lungs as the Gajapati was trying to free himself from the chain. And the baby was, crying at top of his lungs. The baby was crying very bitterly and blindly trying to crawl away. And the baby really wanted to crawl away. So Gajapati gave up and he backed up. He shook his head and gathered the baby to him as baby was crying bitterly. So now the Gajapati changed his tactics, changed his mind, and he stood perfectly still. So he stood very quietly, very close to the tree, and he just he was watching hyenas. And the hyenas were hungry, bold, and began to close in. Since the hyenas were very hungry, they were very bold also, okay, and they began to close in. They were watching the elephant with respect, but they did not allow for the slack of the chain. So the hyenas, they were very hungry. They really wanted to eat the baby, but there was a elephant who protect the baby. So who is protecting the baby? So they were watching the elephant with a respect. So the Gajapati struck like lightning and in a moment got one hyena under his forefeet. So when the hyenas were getting closer, at that moment, the Gajapati struck like a lightning. Very quickly, they attacked the hyena and then got one hyena under his feet. And then almost at once, struggle was over. The hyena was struggling over to free himself, but the body stamped into pulp. But the elephant stamped the body of the hyena and killed him with the squeal of trump and rage. And then again the elephant make a loud sound and threw the carcass aside. The elephant is now really very angry and he threw the body of the hyenas aside. It scattered the others who made off, leaving elephant and baby in peace for an hour or two. So when they saw the anger of an elephant, okay, who killed one hyenas also, the other, and they really scared and they leave the elephant and the baby for an hour or two. Pillowed in dust and exhausted by hunger, the baby lay half sleeping, half sobbing, and sucked at the stove of sugar cane that Gajapati offered him. So now elephant is also very tired, okay, and he is also very hungry. And then, you know, the baby was sleeping on the dust. He was really very hungry, and he was half sleeping. And then half sobbing, he was crying also, okay, he was sobbing. And then the baby was sucked a stop of sugar cane that Gajapati offered him. And then the elephant make a baby warm by his breath, and then the baby sleep. A little after midnight, the Gajapati dozed too, a little later in the midnight, Gajapati also fall asleep. Presently, the baby stared, sat up and began to crawl away. And then the baby began to crawl away. He was already out of reach when the elephant woke up. So the baby was already out of reach from the elephant when the elephant wake up in the morning. In the gray of early morning, Gajapati saw the hyenas coming back. So in the gray light of the morning, the Gajapati saw that the hyenas were again coming back, and the babies are several yards away. Now the baby is already out of reach from the elephant, okay, he already crawled several yards away. Now he forced out the full length of his range, and the iron links beat into his fresh blood, poured down. The Gajapati put all his strength to free himself from the tree, and he jumped, and the blood coming out of his body because he was really wounded. And the hyena saw their chance and darted in, and the hyena saw their chance and they attacked the baby. At the same moment, the great tree gave and smashed down upon the elephant and the baby together, breaking branches and rushing leaves covered them both. And when the hyena saw their chance and attacked the baby, at the same moment the great tree gave and smashed down upon the elephant. The great tree fell down, it's uprooted, okay, and fell down and smashed down upon the elephant and the baby together. Now the baby and elephant both are under the tree, breaking branches and rushing leaves cover them both, okay, with the branches breaking down and all the leaves cover both the elephant and the baby. The violence sent the hyenas off in a flash, and they did not return. And that when the hyena saw that violence of an elephant, okay, they ran away and they didn't came back. When the Karim and his wife ran gasping into camp, they saw only the fallen tree and the Gajapati under it, their baby. So finally the Karim and wife, they were back to the camp, but what they saw was only the fallen tree, the fallen mango tree, and the Gajapati under it. They were not able to find their baby. They tore their way into the leaves and branches. So they clear all the leaves and branches. They try to find out their baby. Beneath it all, the child lay sleeping in the curl of the elephant trunk. So finally, they found that the baby is sleeping in the curl of the elephant. His mother in tears snatched him up. So the mother's, she was crying because she was not able to find his child. And then finally, they saw that the child is sleeping on the trunk of the elephant. So she snatched him up, and he was very dirty and scratched but whole. So his whole body was full of scratch and very dirty. And Gajapati, he lay with closed eyes beneath the tree, and the Gajapati was still beneath the tree with the closed eyes. He lay with the closed eyes beneath the tree. Fool, traitor, raged Karim. So Karim was very angry towards the Gajapati, and he called Gajapati fool, traitor, unfaithful animals, then. So was the baby nothing to thee that thou wouldest break loose and leave him? The baby was nothing to the Gajapati. He just wanted to free himself and go away. So he took his axe and began to free the elephant, watched by his wife, who stood with her son in her arms and trembled still after her knight's adventure. So the Karim took an axe and he began to cut all the branches and leaves of the tree to free elephant, watched by his, and his wife was watching there, okay, with the baby on in her arms, and she was still trembling after her night adventures. Okay, actually what happened was, to the drop her water jar into the deep rapids had been bad enough, then as she tried to recover it to be swept down, the stream had been a nightmare. So when she went to fetch the water from the river, she dropped the water jar into the river, and when she tried to recover it, it swept towards the downstream. And then Karim has raced off down river to look for her. So Karim also went after her when she didn't came back, but Karim also lost in the jungle. So at dawn they found each other and both rushed home to the child. So when before the morning they found each other in the jungle, and then they rushed towards the camp to see the baby. Now panting and grunting, Karim cleared away the branches and undid Gajapati's chain. So now Karim was really with a quick breath, okay, and he was very much angry over the elephant, and he cleared all the branches, and he will die of his injuries, talked the woman. And the woman said that the elephant will die of his injuries because the elephant was very injured. But the elephant got his front feet on to the ground and heaved free of the last branches. And then when the Karim cleared the branches, then that time he got his front feet on the ground and he heaved himself free from the last branches. He was up now. He stand up and brushed bleeding and shaking. The elephant was, he was badly injured and he was bleeding and he was shaking. The worthless traitor, the Karim told the animal bitterly. So the Karim still angry upon the elephant, and he said that the worthless traitor, you are no worth to be trust. So you are very unfaithful. So the big elephant stood and sucked his trunk in shame. When the Karim was scolding elephant, the elephant stood still, sucked his trunk in shame, and he was really regrets, for his wrong doing. So look, gasped the woman, and then the woman noticed something where Gajapati had heaped himself free from the branches. Since Gajapati was very big, a giant elephant, so when he stood up from that time, this had parted the disclosed the body of the hyena. So there was a body of the hyena which the Karim wife see. And then the hyena tracks were everywhere. Then they noticed that there were hyena's tracks everywhere. Finally, the Karim and his wife come to know about the real story behind the fallen tree. And Gajapati was no traitor. And then finally, they realized that Gajapati was not a traitor. Actually, he was saving the baby. He gave his all the efforts. He didn't worry about himself, and he saved a baby like a mother, like a parent. And there followed such words of praise that made Gajapati lift his head and blink. And then when the Karim and his wife come to know the real story, they praised the elephant with such a words, and then the Gajapati lift his head and he blink. So that is the end of the story. Thank you.